I grew a pour. Anybody else? Right? You ever catch yourself still doing pouring shit? Right? Like, you ever try to put shampoo back in the bottle? You know what I'm talking about? Right? When you squeeze out and you're just like, oh my god, this is too much shampoo. I'm not gonna waste it. I'm not gonna waste it. This is L'Oreal. I'm gonna make a little hand comb. I'm gonna get it up to the nozzle. I'm gonna give it a couple of pfff. Save that for tomorrow. It's tomorrow shampoo. You ever hope your car magically heals itself overnight? You're bored. You're bored. Right? You know, your car starts making some weird noise, you're like, I'm gonna let that sit overnight. Right? And the amazing thing is that sometimes it works. You ever come out the next day and you're like, oh my god. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for healing my heart. You could not afford that this month. That's what I love about doing comedy. I think comedy reminds us we're all the same. Right? It shows us that we all go through the same things. Right? Like, you ever take a step that wasn't there? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about? You're just like... Right? Or you leave this moment and you just jam yourself? You're just like... Anybody see that? Anybody see that? Right? You're like, nobody okay? I'm cool. See? We all go through these things. It's just you. It's everybody. Right? You ever been sitting in a red light and the car next to you starts rolling forward? But you think you're rolling backwards. You know that, right? Right? You have that senior moment, you're like, what's happening? Am I in reverse? Is this the break? The hell is going on here? So you thought that was just you. You thought you were the only one that did that. And that was everybody. We all did. This one's for the guys. Guys, you ever try to piss clean your toilet? Right? Right? And you know you shouldn't. You know you shouldn't. But you think to yourself, I can bank it. Ever wondered how piss winds up on the floor?
Please tell me. Please.
Your man tried to bank it. I know you've seen it. I know you, all you might have seen it. He's like, how do you miss such a huge target? I'm trying to do a little light cleaning for you, ladies. I'm telling you, I'm good. I loved all the build-up to that. Like, ladies, if you ever wondered how piss winds up on the floor, and the lady in the back goes, oh, tell me! Well, it's kind of everything I was talking about right up till then. There's gonna be no major reveal here. It's exactly what I was just saying. Nice to see some seniors here tonight, right, seniors? Oh. Look at that. Oh, seniors, like. I've played this game before. I don't trust this little man. Don't act so innocent. Right, seniors? You like to act like, well, I never. Oh, yeah, you did. And you did it a lot. Just because it happened in the past. And I know all about you because it's a different world for seniors. That's right. I don't know if you guys know this. According to the Center for Disease Control, the fastest growing STD group in America is senior citizens. It's true, right? It's totally true. Because it's because of Viagra. They got the Viagra. They're not using condoms or nothing. They're giving each other shit we haven't had since the 50s. All of a sudden, we got whooping crotch, rumble seat, tap out a ding dong, like all kinds of weird shit. And here's the other part, this is all true, you can look it up. They're having senior center orgies. Would you go down there to see your grand-grand? Your meemaw? You open the door, the whole room looks like a pool of melted candles. All the old guys are chasing the little senior ladies around like, come here, Myrtle. Look what I made for you. Oh God. You guys make some dust babies, what do you say? Gay. buzzing about? Why do we still call this a phone? I don't know about you, but being a phone is like number 17 on the list of shit I do. Right? Think about everything else you do with this more than use it as a phone. Right? Text and email and Twitter and Facebook and taking pictures of the maps and internet searches and music and watching movies. Then all of a sudden, bling, oh my God, it's a phone. Right? And by the way, being a phone is what this does the worst. Right? Think about it. It does everything else better than being a phone. You ever been out in the middle of nowhere and the maps still work but you can't make a call? How is that possible? It seems like the maps is a much more complicated operation. But there it is. Totally fine. Can't call anybody. We gotta stop calling it a phone and just call it what it is. God. This is our God. You don't believe me? You ever lose it? Right? You're like, oh my God. Oh my God. Where's my phone? Have you seen, oh my God, where's my phone? Somebody call me. Someone call me. Check your vaccine. I'm seeing your vaccine. Somebody call, oh my God. Right? This is our God. We talk to it like it's God. Oh God, I'm so lonely. Can you find someone to love me within 2 miles? And there are many paths to God, right? There's Verizon. That's like Christianity because it's certain it's the best. Then there's Sprint, that's like Buddhism because it's unlimited everything. And then there's AT&T, that's like Islam because it's legit, but I'm exactly trusting. And then there's T-Mobile. That's like Scientology. Because nobody takes that shit seriously. I love it. Everybody likes that joke except for T-Mobile customers. Is it too late to get a little keyboard that's in alphabetical order? Is this some technological challenge that they just cannot overcome? They're just like, sorry, that's how it was on a typewriter 100 years ago. We gotta keep it. This is not how I learned the alphabet. Either give me a little keyboard in alphabetical order, or we gotta start teaching children the alphabet in the order that's on the keyboard. Right? That would make sense. Right? Think about it. It's not that hard. All you gotta do is rewrite the song. Right? Q-W-E-R-T-Y-U I-O-P-A-S-D-F G-H-J K-L-Z X-C-V-B-N-M with me. Thank you for applauding that. You have no idea how hard it was to memorize. Oh, mind blowing. Oh, try it. I encourage you. On the way home, you'll be like, cute. Okay, try that again. Cute. That guy's a genius. That's the thing, that technology's weird to me. I'm not all down with all the technology. You know, like they got the Apple Watch now. Right, anybody got this? Okay, the Apple Watch, it tracks your pulse, your heartbeat. And it'll tell you things. Like, psst, in there. Getting a little worked up, bro. Getting a little accelerated. Breathe. Okay, I don't want this. I don't need this. Right? I don't need my watch. Because here's the thing, okay? I don't do it all the time, but occasionally, you know, on occasion, I will indulge in a bit of the cocaine. And the last thing I need is a wrist snitch. Going off. What are you doing? You are 46 years old. You gotta stop. And that's the thing, I don't trust it. I don't think you can keep it secret. I feel like it's telegraphing everything back to the mothership. I'm getting a phone call from my doctor just like, Greg, is there anything you'd like to tell me? No, doc, I don't, we don't have an appointment or dinner or something. Or, I don't know, were you doing wind sprints at 3:28 in the morning? I was like, well, they don't call it 24-hour fitness for nothing. I feel like she just realized I was talking about cocaine. I feel like it took a lot of you a long time to decipher that that's what I was talking about. I go, cocaine, you're like, what's cocaine? Is that like stevia? Is that one of those zero calorie sweeteners? It's a good thing I explained it to you. If you guys want to go to Starbucks in the morning, yeah, give me that with two cocaine. That girl wants to do some kicking. That's the thing though, you know, the doctor thing. You know, you gotta lose weight. You gotta get healthy, Greg. I try. You know?
Just stop.
What was that?
What? You want some cocaine?
That's probably what made her speak that way. He's just like, back up! Back up, back up! I didn't even. I just asked her to repeat, he's like, no. I just meant to interrupt the show. I didn't think you'd be interested. Now, if you don't mind, will you get that cocaine? I was trying to eat healthy, man. Here's what I did. I tried to eat healthy. I went and got a three salad plate combination. The first salad was a beet salad with walnuts. The second salad was a vegan taco salad. Woo! You hear what's wrong with America. And the third salad was a gluten-free pasta salad. Let me tell you something. It took two pizzas to get the taste of that shit out of me. Listen, you gotta lay off all that broccoli and focus on your cheeses and Skittles. Be like, thank you, Doc. I knew it. And it's not like I don't work out. I do work out, but when I work out like a fat kid. Like when I work out, in my mind, I'm just earning fast food credits. Some Kentucky Fried Chicken. Find your kids. see, now I don't know where I deserve it. I'm paying for it in advance. And that's the thing, you know, that's what I realized. I don't actually want to be thin. I want to be naturally thin. Do you know those people? You know, right? The ones with the high metabolism. Right? They don't gotta try. They don't have to think about it. They just eat whatever they want and just stay skinny. Don't you hate these people? Oh, is that one of them? Oh, I just want to kick you in the face. And they flaunt it too. They flaunt it. Right? They're just eating pizza with donut toppings. It's so tragic. Because they're fighting every instinct in their being. It's like, do you have a side salad? Yes, a fat-free vinaigrette, fat-free vinaigrette. You just want to be like, get the buffalo chicken strips. You know that's what you want. Live your life. And that's the thing, though. If you are naturally thin, God bless you. Enjoy your skinny life. Don't get hit by a bus. Because the bus could hit me, but the natural padding, I'm protected. I'll just be like, boom. Naturally thin, God bless you, enjoy your thin life, but do me a favor and never complain about it. Have you ever heard a skinny person complain? Right? Right? They complain about being thin? I have this one friend, she's a sweet gal, but she's always saying things like, you guys think I don't want to gain weight? I would love to gain weight, you guys. I can't gain a pound, can't gain a pound. I'm like, fuck yeah! My blood type is ranch. You think I don't eat, guys? I eat so much food, I can't get a pill. I sweat when I read. They don't make skinny jeans in 3630. Getting older, man. All my friends have babies. And all the babies, so my Facebook feed is all these baby pictures. Which is nice, I like it. I love seeing the babies. They're adorable. Okay. Someone's upset she doesn't have a baby yet. delete it. Look at her showing off their baby. You can have one too. I'm pretty sure you can get started on it tonight. Have a couple shots of tequila, your chances go up incrementally. But it's true, right? But the Facebook, all these baby pictures, but here's the thing. A buddy of mine posted a picture of his baby son with no diaper. I'm not gonna lie to you, it was a big dick baby. I wish there was some other way to say that. Right there on the Facebook page. This is a big dick baby. And I even showed it to a girlfriend of mine. She was like, no, Greg, you don't understand. Sometimes when babies are born, oh my God, that's a big dick baby. And I felt like the baby kind of knew it. And all I could think to myself was, can I like this? Because we all know the NSA is reading our shit. I don't want to be dragged in for an interview like, excuse us, Mr. Wilson. But according to our records, you like big dick big dicks. There's a difference. Check the video. See the thing? Does anyone else think that like the government can see you through the webcam? Right? Do you cover it? Right? Do other people think you're crazy when they see it covered? And you're like, no, you're the crazy one for not covering it. Right? I totally think they're watching us through that. And I just feel like somewhere there's like a whole server in a government silo of just me and my computer just... You must just watch that all day. Does this guy not have a job? What is that? All day he does this? What is this? How old do you have to be? Excited to see someone drinking water. Look at you. I got my hair cut recently by this Russian girl. Do you guys know any Russians?
Yeah.
They're very different people. The Russians from Russia. They're very different. I'll tell you what happened. She gave me a haircut. At the end of the haircut, she looks at me, she goes, oh, look at you. You're so handsome. Don't blame me if you get raped. Crazy. probably couldn't tell by looking at me, but I'm black. No, this is true. This is true. No, it's true. My grandmother was half black. And I did one of those DNA tests, and I am 6% black. That's all you need. Adorable Malaysian lady on his giant black country. So I'm trying to ride the black stallion. He's so big! Went off. Breathe. You guys are great.